concrete everywhere. It's the most widely used construction material in the world. It's materials that were available at the time. And it's just sand, stone, and cement and water. There's a wide variety of facilities that have already exceeded their design life, and we'd like to be able to extend the design life, and that often means the period between a 50-year-old structure and a 100-year-old structure. We'll now have concrete properties to fill in that 50 to 100-year period. These samples have been under tender loving care by the University of Wisconsin since 1910. Dean Withey was instrumental in the early part of this program. After his contribution, it was picked up by Kurt F. Wendt, and his name also appears on a number of the study reports.
That's close.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, for what?
Has 1 million pound capacity, which is a fairly large capacity for machines of this type. And it's controlled electronically. The large head that's over the concrete cylinder weighs 22,000 pounds. Using hydraulic pressure, we'll be applying 50,000 pounds per minute. The amount of force that's going to push down on the cylinder will fail long before we get to 1 million pounds, unless we're in for a 100-year surprise. As you look at it, it's not very great. It's very dusty. Not your ideal concrete specimen by any means. Cement gains strength by hydrating. In other words, it reacts with water. And this specimen here was denied water since it was just out in the air for 100 years.
I'll go back up.
The one that they're going to test next, however, has been in water, so we would expect that to have reached its full strength potential.
Water. 4,200,
okay. Yeah. So we're right in the ballpark where they were at 50 years.
This is a 100-year specimen. And we just cracked the surface so we would not get any stress fractures. And then we lapped and polished the surface of the piece so that we could look at it under an optical microscope. From here, we can take a very small piece. We put a conductive coating on the surface of the sample, along with some carbon tape, so that when we're looking at it under a scanning electron microscope, we can make sure that we get a very nice image. So in these 100-year specimens, we're specifically looking for hydrated versus unhydrated cement, so that we can see after the 100 years, has all the cement hydrated and has it reached its sort of ultimate strength.
The contribution will be as the entire history of the life of these concrete specimens, what they were made out of, what the cement chemistry was at the time, the environmental conditions that they've been exposed to, and then the properties at various points in time, from 1 week to 2 months, to 10 years, to 30 years, to 50 years, to 100 years. I don't know of anyone who has that kind of complete history for a material like concrete over that long a period. It's a credit to Withey and some of the originators of this research that they had not only the foresight in the outcome of the research, but also the confidence in the institution that they could initiate an experiment knowing full well that it would extend way beyond their lifetime, and yet that research would be brought to fruition and shared with the world. And I think that's a real testimony to Wisconsin, the Wisconsin idea, how we approach research at Wisconsin, in some sense, that hasn't changed over 100 years and is still present and with us today. So for me, it's a real honor to be able to pick this up and to have been able to carry it through.